I read the comments on this one. All of y'all out there, what is wrong with y'all? Y'all never study astronomy? I did. There's over 4 billion men charter class planets. That's 4 billion Earths. And you think about it, third planet, third rock from the sun, every galaxy got a third rock from the sun, which is capable of supporting human life. So, being that God is omnipotent, why the hell would y'all think that we the only ones? We ain't the only ones. And since the president taking money out of that so-called war effort, he need to put that in the NASA, dog. We need some starships. Because this planet getting too motherfucking full. And there's just too much shit going on because it just ain't no fucking room. And when human beings feel cramped, man, they commit crimes. Start killing motherfuckers and shit because there's just too many motherfuckers in the way. You don't believe me? Go out driving. See how many, go out driving when you in a hurry and see how many motherfuckers is in your way. Damn. We need some starships in this camp. Believe me. I want to get off this rock. I don't want to die to get off this rock. Me, personally? Hell. I'd rather you take NASA, build some starships, and call it Starfleet Command. Shit. Let's get the fuck off this motherfucker. Spread out. Shit. It's 2010. We supposed to have starships by now. Remember that movie, The Space Odyssey? I mean, they ships were slow, but goddamn, they was off this motherfucking planet. Goddamn. We need some space. We need some growing room. We need some chilling room. We need some elbow room. You know what I'm saying? We need some elbow, especially out there in China. God damn. And Japan? God damn. Shit. 25% of the world's population is in them two countries alone. Talking about needing some fucking space? Damn. They already invented a way for motherfuckers that's quadriplegics and paraplegics to walk. You know what I'm saying? Cyborg devices they could put into your body. Nanotechnology. Come on, man. All this shit we got now, we need to start putting this shit to use. Especially stem cell research, because I'm really a fan of that shit. Come on, man. Anything, any kind of studying that we doing to help us live more than 100 years, more than 150 years, look, we need to start putting money into that shit to help us live longer. I mean, like, damn. Everything on this motherfucking planet will kill us. Shit, everything. You don't think that we need to get off this motherfucker? Everybody worried about global warming and all that. Look here, man. If we had starships, wouldn't be no fucking global warming. Because you know why? It'd be less motherfuckers on this planet driving. It'd be less motherfuckers on this planet commuting. It'd be less motherfuckers on this planet, period. Shit. Let's go up there. Let's reach the stars. Let's travel in them. Shit, warp drive, baby. Engines all ahead full, warp 8. Shit, goddamn. Me, personally, I would like to find some pointy-eared bastards out in another solar system. Come on now. We ain't even been to the next solar system yet. How foolish are we? And then aliens, you know why the motherfuckers come down here in secret? Because the motherfuckers already know, as a species, that's all of us, every last 6-7 billion, however many motherfuckers it is on the planet, that's all of us, are scared as fuck if a ship just come flying down, motherfuckers get all in a panic, in an uproar, start crashing their cars and shit, like in the movies. Come on, man. You know the motherfuckers is watching our movies and they like, wow, this is a primitive race. I don't think they gonna make it out of their 21st century. To be honest with you, I would like to make it out of the 21st motherfucking century, okay? I would like to personally live to see the 22nd and the 23rd century. I would like stem cell research to get so good that it becomes the fountain of youth, you know? You know what I'm saying? The Fountain of Youth. And what's this light behind me? I don't know what the fuck that is. Well, I don't know what the fuck that shit is. Oh, that's this side over here. That's the mirror. Okay, cool. Anyway, I'd like to make it into the 22nd or 23rd century alive. Traveling the stars, beam me up, Scotty, to all that shit. Everything in Star Trek or Battlestar Galactica. Battlestar Galactica. Stargate Atlantis. All this shit is possible. We got the theories for it. We got the technology to build it. Hell, did y'all see the new Star Trek? I don't know, dog. It was this ongoing theory back in the day. If it was in the movies, that shit really exists. I know y'all seen the new Star Trek movie. That looked like some shit that we could build right the fuck now. I mean, damn. You see the engine room in that motherfucker? It looked like a boiler room. Shit. You see them shuttles? Damn. They look like BART trains with engines. Oh, you don't know what BART is, that Bay Area Rapid Transport. That's the so-called subway system out here in the Bay that is completely fucking useless and expensive to ride. But anyway, I'm talking about Starships, not BART. But it looked like a BART car with, you know, with nacelles on it and warp drive. Shit, man. We need that kind of shit. And come on, man. Energy matter transfer? Come on, man. It's a gang of chemists out there right now that could probably create a device that'll make an energy matter transfer device. I mean, damn. That's what beaming is. I mean, like breaking down your molecules and then shooting them through air, and then you just re-put all your shit, reattach it together again. I mean, like, it's some scary shit, you know. It's some scary shit, you know. I wouldn't want to be the first motherfucker to get transported somewhere that way. But if I see a motherfucker, it worked perfectly, hell yeah. I'll step on the pad. Look at man, beam me to Mars. Shit. Shit. Come on now, beam me to Mars. Beam me up to the ship. Because to be honest with you, I don't like flying. I'm afraid of heights, but I'm not afraid to be in a starship in space. Because you know why? We can't fall. There's no gravity in space, baby. If something happened to the fucking ship, it's just going to float. That's it. It ain't going to crash. The safest mode of travel known to man is traveling through space. The only thing you got to worry about traveling through space is if life support go out. And let's believe you me, we ain't going to let life support go out. It ain't happening. Look, we might float for a few months until the engines are fixed, but we ain't going to die and we ain't going to fall. So all of y'all out there that say, I don't believe in that. I don't think that's possible. Y'all some dumbasses, man. You real dumb. I mean, like, all of us Trekkies, we want the shit to happen. You know what I'm saying? Here we go right here. Dear Mr. President and NASA, hired the greatest minds in MIT history, put them all together and tell them, look, develop a warp engine. Look, it'll only take 10 years to perfect the ship, okay? Then all we got to do is leave a warp signature. Hey, maybe another species, maybe another humanoid species from another galaxy. Not galaxy, that's too far away. But maybe another species from another solar system will say, oh, wow, humans finally evolved. And then we can have the United Federation of Planets. I mean, damn, shit. What's wrong with knowing other species on other different planets? Me, personally, I would like to live on another fucking planet. I'd like to live on several planets. I mean, damn, shit. 10 years on this planet, 10 years on this planet. See that kind of technology? They could boost our technology? Shit, man. Let me tell y'all, man. Y'all motherfuckers need to quit being scared. And the president, he need to order NASA to create warp drive.